Get your backpack ready. Let's brainstorm another trip. This week, our whirlwind tour takes us through the Hellenistic period, the time between the conquests of Alexander the Great and the rise of the Roman Empire. This is the period after Alexander when Mesopotamian astronomy spread to the West. During the Hellenistic period, the intellectual center of activity shifted from Athens to Alexandria in Egypt. At this time, being Greek referred not to someone who lived in one of the little city-states, but to a new world culture that spread as a unifying force throughout the Mediterranean and beyond. I hope you'll make some meaningful and unexpected discoveries this week as we explore the strange new worlds of Hellenistic mathematics, medicine, astronomy, and geography. Despite the brevity of our visit, our aim will be to get to know the science of this time in terms of its Hellenistic culture. We'll not be like tourists in Alexandria who seek fast food at McDonald's. What interests you most about the Hellenistic period? What comes to mind when you think of Alexander the Great? Do teachers really touch the future? Consider these teacher-student generations. Socrates was the teacher of Plato. Plato was the teacher of Aristotle. Aristotle was the teacher of Alexander the Great. Alexander the Great changed the world. What aspects of a teacher do you admire most? And do you think you'll find these qualities in Socrates, Plato, and Aristotle? Why are so many people interested in Greek culture? Does Greek culture have any special meaning for you? Do you like Greek food? Have you traveled to Greece? Do you read or speak Greek? What is your favorite Greek story or your favorite movie about Greece? Alexandria, a city in the Nile Delta of Egypt, displaced Athens as the preeminent center of learning and scholarship in the Hellenistic period. Cleopatra, who died in 30 BCE, was the last of the Hellenistic dynasty who ruled from Alexandria. What do you find interesting about the city of Alexandria or about Cleopatra? The library at Alexandria was a now-vanished museum or temple to the muses. You learned something about the Library of Alexandria in the Shape of the Earth unit, because this is the place where Eratosthenes served as librarian when he measured the circumference of the earth. What else have you heard about the Library of Alexandria? Have you visited Egypt, Cairo, Alexandria? Did you appreciate any sites dating from the Hellenistic era between Alexander the Great and Cleopatra? As always, when we're planning a trip, we want to better understand what people in this place and time were up to. So what are some similarities between Hellenistic culture and our culture today? How might these similarities help us to understand science in the Hellenistic time? But what are some differences between Hellenistic culture and our culture today? How might these differences pose an obstacle to our understanding of Hellenistic science? What do you think might be the chief barrier that obstructs modern appreciation of Hellenistic science? Please share your thoughts on these things. What are your starting assumptions?